Hey everyone, how are we doing today? First, I want to say thank you to Rosemary and the staff at Holston Valley Unitarian Universalist Church for inviting me to share my testimony and a few words in honor of Pride Month in order to shine a light on the LGBT community. I was happy to make this video to participate in this virtual service, which I think is a great resource, you know, for those of us who miss services and fellowship. First off, right, who the heck is this guy? I'm Aaron Capener. I'm turning 25 in a few days, and I have a small business here in Kingsport, Tennessee. I help LGBTQ plus businesses with their online social presence, social media, websites, content creation, and I also run a YouTube channel where I educate people on what it's like to be trans in today's society, but also help those who are like me navigate their own journey to their authenticity. So that brings me to kind of what God has put on my heart to shine a light on today. Over the last few weeks, I've had multiple signs pointing me to, you know, sit down and do this video. This one's a big for me because I've grown up in the church. I have a very complicated experience with the church, as many LGBTQ plus people rightfully do. And an emotionally heavy relationship with God is how I would describe my relationship with Him. I've had subscribers that would love to see a video about being trans and Christian, how I was able to reconcile my faith with my gender identity and still identify as a Christian. I'd like to preface my answer with the fact that these are my opinions, right? I'm not someone who shoves my religion in other people. Your religion with God or your relationship with God or that like lack thereof isn't my business. It's between you and Him, in my opinion. I'm very passionate about what I believe and why I believe what I do, but I do not believe that you're less than me or going straight to hell if your feelings are different than mine. I love you for you, and that's my job here on earth, in my opinion. So to be sure I answer the question, first and foremost, I can reconcile my faith because for me, facing God is no longer like a battle of intense emotion that I can't even process, right? When I saw people praising God or being religious, it made me so angry because I saw firsthand the judgmental people that can be in the church. And I didn't want anything to do with that picture that they had painted of a Christian, right? For me, my relationship with God is about what He did for me in my life, where He bailed me out, you know, as a young child and helped me rise through the ashes of trauma. In my opinion, I didn't have the strength to stand up from that and to survive my testimony without Him. You know, I believe that in every step, hurdle, hill, mountain, and hurricane that I went through in my childhood, God was with me. I believe that. I believe He strategically placed people to guide me through all of that and give me emotional lift that reminded me and left me knowing that this was not going to last forever. So my relationship with God is much like someone would have with a parent or a grandparent, but also like a best friend. I talk to God just like I would talk to a friend or an elder, you know, real authentically. Christianity is literally defined as the religion based on the person and the teachings of Jesus of Nazareth. And I follow Jesus, the red words of the Bible, and I believe He is inside of me. And I aspire to be more like Him every day, to be better every day. If you asked me how I reconciled my faith, I would be lying to you if I just said I worked through it and got it done and focused. And but because when I was less than 6 years old, He began rescuing me. So our relationship began early on in my life. As I got older and adverse childhood experiences, you know, slowly began processing and showing up different times in my life in different situations. And honestly, my memory of my childhood is really fragmented, but I can tell you what I went through, and I can tell you who was with me that helped me through each and every one of those single hard times. The biggest test for me was middle school by far. My relationship with God throughout my middle school years was absolutely treacherous. I mean, I was trying my best to follow like all these rules that had been laid out for me in the Bible I had known and I had learned in my childhood years, but it was different this time. You know, the Bible was terrifying in my susceptible preteen eyes. You know, I was scared to be who I was or even hold hands in fear of God's wrath. I would write FROG on my wrist, and whenever I felt myself thinking of any girl in that way, I would just pray and just pray that He would make me stop feeling these things. God brought me through a lot growing up, and this bond and this peace that I had learned to grow with as a child was my saving grace in middle school. I knew that he had to have loved me for helping me get to where I am now, and after beating myself up for years, I realized God wouldn't want me to hate myself anymore. He would not want me to constantly be putting myself down and feeling like I was going to hell no matter what I did. And in the church, I was told I couldn't return to church camp because I was a bad influence on the other kids because of my refusal to repent. You know, between this and the exhaustion of damaged relationships with judgmental members of the church, I decided to just praise him in my own way. I didn't want it to be about who was praising the loudest or the hardest or dancing or whose hands were raised in the highest in the air. I mean, it wasn't about how often you read your Bible, how many hours you put in a day. I wasn't about the public display. My relationship with God is between me and nobody else, and the same goes for you. And these are for a few reasons. One, we've been through a lot together. He's seen every single tear, heartbreak that no one else saw, crying, real intimate moments. I mean, think about that in your own life, like the hardest times that you faced, he was there for you. I mean, you may not have felt it, you may have felt alone and despairing and just so sad, but the whole time he was there. You know, and like secondly, he calmed me through my trauma, hysteria, many years of mania. After years of relying on him to calm me in the storm, you begin to develop a relationship with this feeling of peace inside you. You know, and that's known as the Holy Spirit. And thirdly, I find it comforting knowing that he knew who I was. He knew who I would be today from the time that I was just a seed, you know, and I know God loves me. God has been the only person who has not abandoned me. Even when I couldn't see myself getting to 18 and having a life of my own, he could. He could see that for me. He held me and picked me back up and brushed off my knees and was like, all right, let's keep going. It reminds me of Judah Smith in a new song. He's talking about how, you know, God speaks to us and he's saying, I'm right here, my child. I won't go anywhere. You're in the palm of my hand. My arms are wrapped around you. When you sleep, I'll watch over you. I'll take care of your loved ones. Your future is in my hands. I forgive you. I'm your friend. It'll be all right. Reconciling your faith is realizing that most people are breaking a commandment by constantly ridiculing you. Even without realizing it, they preach with hearts full of vain and attempt to try and speak for God. You may stand for the Bible in a specifically translated version of the verse, but you do not get to verbally assault people with your belief of any topic. Foolish people are using God's name to justify their own prejudices and their hatred for other people. And the sad part is that there are loving, compassionate, LGBTQ+ friendly Christians and they're being overshadowed by these terrible acts of hatred. The true meaning of the Lord's name in vain is using the Bible to beat up other people. In some cases, it drives people to murder. I mean, it's sad too, because the Bible shouldn't be weaponized. It should be used to find inspiration and unconditional love and strength, and all of which are strong emotions that we as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, non-binary people, we're not used to being able to find unconditional love or peace or strength or inspiration from those around us. At least not in the capacity that God's love can do. Now, I don't ever want to be associated with the Jesus that hates gays. My Jesus doesn't hate. My Jesus doesn't spew hateful things. My Jesus doesn't judge other people based on the color of their skin. That he made them, I believe he made them perfectly colored in his image. I believe, you know, I believe that the Bible can be a pathway to learn more about God and his power and his love. It wasn't an easy process, and there's still aspects of my faith and I'm still working on. But no one's ever done trying to be better. I pray I'll never be satisfied with who I am because I know I can always do better. I aspire to grow closer to the Lord and have him use me as a vessel in any way that I can be of use. I don't know what he's got planned for me in any way. I learned a long time ago that my cards are not in my hands, they're in his hands. And when they're in his hands, I never lose. If you're watching this video right now, I want you to know that you're loved. I hope that you are all having a wonderful day. And please remember that you're beautifully and wonderfully made. I want to leave you with one remaining thought. God loves you. God loves you for who you are. Keep him close. Talk with him. Because at the end of the day, there's absolutely nothing that can separate you from his unconditional love.